Rockets aren't really rocket science. You get the propellant together, light them on fire, and eject them out the back end of the vacuum. Simple enough. Yeah, no. Okay, but how do you move that much fuel and make that much smoke and fire enough to propel something as big as, say, the Falcon 9 that is over 70 meters tall and weighs millions of pounds? That's where things get interesting and technically difficult. You see, propellant isn't going to wake up one day and say, "Oh, I gotta burn today." No, you have to move the propellant in the burning chambers. Some call it the combustion chamber. Let's drop the word propellant for now and call it fuel stuff. So you place a very powerful pump to move all the stuff in the fuel tank to the burning chambers. So far, so good. But then how would you ever power the pump? Pump isn't going to run itself. It's something called a gas generator, which in itself is a small combustion chamber and does nothing except produce gas to power up the turbines, which in turn power up the pumps. So you use a certain amount of fuel stuff brought into the engine to power up the pumps. So, to summarize, the fuel stuff, liquid hydrogen and liquid oxygen, enter the engine and goes immediately into the pumps. After exiting the pump, a small amount of each fuel stuff is tapped off to supply the gas generator. It makes hot high-pressure steam and gaseous hydrogen that are used to drive the turbine connected to the fuel stuff pump. The still warm gas is then dumped along the walls of the nozzle extension to keep that relatively cool. The rest of the fuel stuff goes off in the burning chambers. To do guess what? Get burned. The after products are then ejected out at a very high speed, thus generating thrust and moving your rockets up and up. Oh, and the supersonic nozzle right here? That's there to make the exhaust gases go faster and faster.